हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ मनीष गिरी गोस्वामी। आई एम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स एप्लीकेशन, श्री कृष्णा यूनिवर्सिटी, एंड द सब्जेक्ट दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डील इज़ द वेब डेवलपमेंट। सो बट बिफोर वी गेट इन टू द डिटेल्स ऑफ द एक्चुअल वेब डेवलपमेंट, आई वॉन्ट यू पीपल टू गेट इंट्रोड्यूस्ड टू फ्यू इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्मिनोलॉजी रिलेटेड टू द सब्जेक्ट। सो आई एम गोइंग टू बिगिन विद द वेरी बेसिक thing, and that is internet. Web development is about internet actually. So first of all, we need to understand what is internet, where it came from, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of internet. So this is all we need to understand first before getting into the actual web development thing. So let's begin today's presentation. Okay, so the very first thing that we need to understand is internet. So the question is, what is internet? So internet is actually a vast network that connects computers all over the world. So actually the thing is, there are number of networks related to business, government and academic, and even there are other smaller domestic networks. All these networks are interconnected with each other, and this interconnection of all these networks is called internet. Okay, therefore internet is known as the network of all the other networks. So this is what is called internet. And why do we use it? What is the use of internet? Mostly internet is used for sharing information and to communicate with different people sitting at different part of the world. I'll tell you other benefits of internet. Okay, so these are the advantages of internet. Why do we use internet? So the very first advantage, the very first use of internet, is faster communication. Internet enables communication. People sitting at different part of the world can easily connect and communicate with each other through voice calls, video calls, chatting and emails. So there are number of services available on internet which enables you to connect with people who are sitting at some other part of the world. Next advantage of internet is information resources. So internet is a huge collection of information, means information related to any topic can be searched and found on internet. Any kind of information on any topic under the sun is available on the internet. We all know about Google. You just search for the topic and you will get every information related to that particular topic. So this is another advantage of internet, to find out information related to different topics. Third is entertainment. Obviously, internet is a huge platform for finding resources to entertain us. There are music, movies and games available on internet. Number of services which are offering us music, movies and games. So internet can be used for entertainment also. Next use is social networking. Actually with time, social networking has become very popular on internet because social networking has enabled us to connect with people. We can connect with people who were there in our previous life, maybe from our school days or college days. Those friends that we used to have in our school and college, we can easily find them on internet and connect to them. Then we can also use social networking to connect with people of similar interest. Okay, for example, you may be interested in something and if you want to have a group of people who have similar interest, you can easily find those kind of people on social networking and then you can connect with them. You can find your long lost friends, and you can also use social networking for job, to find out job for yourself. LinkedIn is one website which enables you to find jobs on internet, and then you can also use internet to find, especially the social networking on internet, to find business opportunities. Next is online services. Of course, there are a number of online services available on internet these days. You can buy movie tickets, you can book tickets for your journey, and you can obviously transfer funds, you can pay your utility bills, electricity bills and all, and taxes also. and then you can also use number of e-commerce websites that are available on internet to shop your products. You can buy things on internet on e-commerce websites. So everything which has advantage also has disadvantages also. So there are number of disadvantages of internet. The number one disadvantage of internet is the theft of your personal information. Obviously, when we use internet, we need to provide so many details, so many of our detail on internet. So that detail, that information, that personal information can be theft actually. Like people can gain access to all our information available on the internet. Information available on the internet, for example, our name, our address, our bank details, our credit card details, all this very important information related to us is available on internet, and anybody can gain access to the information, and then they can use all this information for their benefit, right? So this is one disadvantage, the huge disadvantage of internet. Second is spamming. Spamming means actually like so many number of emails can be sent to your system in bulk. So it affects the speed of your network, and it also somewhere it makes our internet slower, and it also makes our network less reliable. Okay, so spamming means when number of bulk emails are being sent to your system, unnecessary emails, useless emails, just to slow down your network or to make it less reliable. Next is pornography. Pornography is a huge problem these days. There are numerous pornographic material available on internet, which is obviously making a wrong impact, a bad influence on the mental health of us, on the mental health of human beings. Next is virus threat. Obviously, internet users are often plagued by virus attacks on their systems. Like people can send viruses to your system through internet, and those viruses can adversely affect your system, right? So these are the disadvantages of internet. Now, where this internet came from, where this whole thing began. So actually there are two events which lead to the invention of internet. The very first event was when Robert W. Taylor developed a network called ARPANET. Okay, ARPANET, the full form of ARPANET is actually in 1973, Robert W. Taylor, Robert W. Taylor made a network for US government and for the laboratories related to US government to transfer large files. So this thing came for the defense. The first agenda can be dated to 1973 when the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, DARPA, create a communication network that would support the transfer of large data files between government and government-sponsored academic research laboratories. Okay, so US Defense Academy made a network to transfer files between government and government-based laboratories to enable research. It was made by Robert W. Taylor in 1973. Later, US government gave permission to open it to more networks, to more people, and then from there it started gaining lots of usages actually. Like so many number of organizations and laboratories started using the network. So first it was called ARPANET, then gradually it became popular, and then they started calling it internet, because it became the interconnected network of number of networks. And the second important event which led to the invention, or which led to the popularity of internet, was the introduction of Apple II. So what happened? In 1977, the company, okay, Apple company made an computer, an affordable computer for individuals and small businesses, and they gave it a name, Apple II. It was made by Apple Computer Inc. Okay, means the company Apple. So it became very popular in schools by 1979, but still the system was not good enough for corporate, right? It was good, but it was not suitable for the usage at the corporate. So IBM was the company which made first personal computer, and it was totally directed towards the corporate. Okay, so Apple company made Apple II, a small affordable computer. Then IBM made PC for corporate. It was a small personal computer, but it was somewhere a little better than Apple II. So it was totally targeted towards corporate. So these were the events, the creation of the creation of ARPANET by Robert W. Taylor for US National Defense Academy, and then the creation of a small affordable computer Apple II by the Apple company, and then a PC by IBM. So this is where this whole thing internet came from, and gradually it started gaining popularity, and then it became very popular from there. So how does internet work actually? See, when you go, suppose you want a telephone connection at home, so what you do? You go to the companies which provides you connection, which provides you telephone connection, then from there you get the telephone connection, and then you start using those telephones. So same for the internet, you need to take connections from companies which are providing you the connection for internet, and those companies are called internet service provider or internet access provider. So these there are number of companies which gives you actually access to the internet, and they can use your telephone connection, they can give you wireless connection, and these days fiber optics have become very popular because fiber optics provide the fastest speed for the internet. So fiber optics have also become very popular. So this is internet service provider. The companies which provide you the access to the internet are called internet service providers, and there are things that you need to look into. Factors to look at while choosing an ISP: speed, what speed of internet the company is providing, what is their consistency, how much reliable the connection is, and how much consistent access to the internet, like the connection is dropping frequently or not. This is what you need to check. And what are the prices, at what price the connection is being provided to you. So there are four companies which are quite popular in our country, in India, which gives you internet connection. One is Bharat Sanchar Nigam Limited, next is Videsh Sanchar Nigam Limited, next is Mahanagar Telephone Nigam Limited, and last is Reliance Communications. Besides these four companies, there are a number of private companies also which are giving you access to internet, so you can go and get an internet connection for yourself from any of these companies, right? And what do we call it? We call it internet service provider. So now next important thing about internet is World Wide Web. See, I just told you about internet, but what do we use it? I just told you that internet is being used for sharing information. So where that information comes from? So the source which gives you information, that source is World Wide Web. English scientist Tim Berners-Lee co-invented the World Wide Web in 1989, Tim Berners-Lee invented World Wide Web. And what is World Wide Web? World Wide Web is a system of interlinked hypertext documents. Okay, actually this is what we need to understand. See, web development means we need to develop websites and we need to develop web pages, and the collection of those web pages and the collection of those websites is called World Wide Web, and they are also called hypertext documents. With a web browser, okay, how do you access those websites? you need an application in your system which is called web browser. There are a number of web browser available for you to access websites. One can view pages that may contain text, images, videos and other multimedia, and they can also navigate between those links. Okay, so World Wide Web is a collection of hypertext documents. We can call them websites, we can call them web pages, and through those websites and web pages, data, information in different forms, maybe in text form, maybe in videos form, maybe in images form, and maybe in different multimedia form, can be delivered to your system. And how does it differ from internet? What is the difference between internet and World Wide Web? Internet is actually a decentralized global network of computers that transfer information with the help of wiring, whereas World Wide Web is a collection of documents or websites that users can access using the internet and a web browser. So this one difference between internet and World Wide Web you need to understand very carefully, because people often confuse them as one thing. So okay, you can call them one thing, but these two are different things. Internet is a decentralized network of computers, and World Wide Web is the collection of websites. So how do you access those websites on your computer? Actually, every web resource has its address. Okay, for example, you have a shelf, suppose in your room, and some books are lying on those shelf. So if I ask you to bring one book from the shelf, so how will I tell you? I'll have to tell you the exact address of that book, that in which room, on which shelf that particular book is lying. So this is what you need to do on the internet. Whenever you want to access some resource or some file on the internet, you need to tell its exact address on the web server. Then from there the file is accessed and then displayed on your system. For example, if you want to open facebook.com, so you'll have to write www.facebook.com on the address part of your web browser. Then only your system will know that this particular website needs to be accessed from the server. Okay, so this is how it works for other websites and resources also. Okay, web browsers utilize the URL to retrieve a file from the computer on which it resides. In other words, it is the global address of documents and other resources on the World Wide Web. A URL is a formatted text string. Okay, it is a text string. I just gave you an example. HTTPS is the name of the protocol. Then www means World Wide Web. Then facebook.com is the actual name of the website that need to be accessed on your system. Okay, in most web browsers, the URL of a web page is displayed on top inside an address bar. The URL was created in 1994 by Tim Berners-Lee. So World Wide Web was invented by Tim Berners-Lee. Web browser was also invented by Tim Berners-Lee. So I hope you've understood what Uniform Resource Locator means. Okay, it is the web address, actually, the address of the resource that you want to access. Resource or file or website or web page, whatever you want to call it. Now, hypertext. What is hypertext? I just told you that www is a collection of hypertext documents. So what is hypertext? Hypertext refers to the text that connects to other documents. Okay, so when you'll go on some website, you will see blue color text, and it is also underlined. So that blue colored text, underlined blue colored text, is actually a link to some other page in the same website, or maybe it is a link to some other website, and that link is called hypertext. You can also call it hyperlink, you can also call it hot link, or you can simply call it link. It is used to jump to another part of the same page or to load a different web page. Okay, for example, within facebook.com, if you want to go, to some profile. You'll have to click on the link of that profile, then that profile will be displayed on your system. And maybe there is some ad going on in Facebook, and if you want to open that ad, you'll click on the link and that page will be opened in new tab. Okay, so that link that is mostly underlined and in blue color, and it is called hyperlink. When you click on some link, it changes its color into magenta color. Okay, when a cursor, when the user returns to a page with a link he or she had already visited, the hypertext words will often be in magenta color, indicating that the link has already been used. Okay, the link has already been used if it displays in magenta color. So this is hypertext, and next is hypertext transfer protocol. So like I just told you, hypertext means links to different web pages, but how do we access it? What actually makes it possible to access those hypertext links? What makes it possible is this protocol. If you'll go on internet and type in some website, you will see this this one term written right in the beginning, HTTP. So what is the full form of HTTP and why do we use it? The full form of HTTP is Hypertext Transfer Protocol, and we use it to enable the communication between web server and your web browser, the client machine. Actually, these are the set of rules for transferring files such as text, graphic, images, sound, video, and other multimedia files on the World Wide Web. Okay, so there are set of rules that have been predefined to make possible the transfer of documents within two system or within like between web server and your computer, web server and client computer. HTTP defines how messages are formatted and transmitted and what actions web servers and browsers should take in response to various commands. So all these rules have been defined under that protocol, that whenever certain kind of message will come, so what action needs to be taken for that message. So it is all defined under hypertext protocol. So these were few important terminology related to internet or website development. In my next lecture, I'll try to bring more detail or maybe more terminology related to web development. Then gradually we will get into the actual web development in the coming classes. And this is it for today. This is it for today's lecture, and I'll see you in another lecture. Thanks for listening to me. Bye-bye.